Good morning to my dear student. In today's lecture, we are going to deal about unit number 1, electrolytic conductivity. Now go for the introduction of this chapter. Electrochemistry is nothing but the branch of physical chemistry which deals with the study of relationship between electrical energy and chemical energy. So, electrolytic conductivity is nothing but the study which includes the electrochemistry. And again, the electrolytic conductivity is again defined as the capacity of substance, that is electrolyte, to conduct electricity. The capacity of substance to conduct electricity is called electrolytic conductivity. Now, you are already familiar with these two terms. Is the conductor and insulator. So what is the definition of conductor? Substance which current conduct electric current. Substance which conduct electric current, or in other words, it is also called the substance which allow the electricity to flow through themselves. So these are the definitions of conductor. Now number of examples are there. All metals are good conductor of electricity. So in example, metals, solution of acids and base. Now totally opposite to conductor, second term is insulator part. Totally opposite to conductor, substance which does not conduct electric current. Substance which does not conduct electric current, it is called insulator. Number of examples are there, but I have selected some limited: glass, mica and ebonites. Now go for the difference between conductor and insulator. In conductor, electrons flow easily between atoms, and totally opposite to insulator, electron flow is difficult between atom. You are already familiar with the conductor. All metals are good conductor. So therefore, the valence electrons in outermost orbit for conductor is 1, 2, 3, whereas in insulator the valence electron between 5 to 8. Conductor having the low electronegativity, whereas insulator having the high electronegativity. Some examples of conductors are like that: silver, copper, gold, aluminium, and number of examples are there. And while there are some example for insulator: mica, glass, rubber and plastic. In this diagram you observe that some examples of conductor and insulator. To left hand side, example for conductors, and to the right hand side, these are the example for insulator. Now there are number of types of conductors, but basically divide into two types. First is metallic conductor. It is also called electronic conductor. And second number, it is called electrolytic conductor. Metallic or electrolytic conductor, and second, electrolytic conductors. So which is called metallic conductor? So therefore, the metals which conduct electricity, they are called metallic conductor. So these are usually metals, metallic rod or wires. How to define the electrolytic conductors? They are the electrolyte, like few salt, aqueous solution of acid, base and salt. Now go for the detailed informations about metallic conductors. So initially, what metallic conductors are normally related to metals. So the metal consists of stationary positive charge, means positive charge is fixed, whereas it is again consists of negatively charged, which is free to move. Negatively charged electron which is free to move. Now go for the working. Very simple working is given. Here go for the diagram. At one side negative charge and at second side positive charge. You already familiar with one phenomena: positive attract negative, negative attract positive. Positive attract negative, negative attract positive. So consider, When a copper wire is placed in an electric field, suppose a metal like copper wire is placed in electric field, the electrons move and carry the negative charge through the metals. In this diagram also, check the arrow which is going right hand side. So therefore, blue dots indicate the flowing of electrons. So from one side, electrons are added and they are going off at other side. So it produces electricity without producing any chemical change. Okay, electrons are only moving. There is no any chemical change. So these are the working of metallic conductor. When copper wire is placed in electric field, electrons move and carry negative charge and they are added at one end and given off at the another end. So in metallic conductor, there is no any chemical change. Now go for this part, that is electrolytic conductor. These are the electrolytes, like the solution of fused acid, base, salt. The electrolyte produce positive and negative ions. The electrolyte produce positive and negative ions. The working is very much simple. Go for this diagram. In this beaker, NaCl electrolyte is there. In this beaker, you have to take a solution of NaCl. Na plus Cl minus. Ionization of electrolyte is like that. Na plus and Cl minus. So go for the working. When electric field is applied, and again in same beaker, two electrodes are deep, one having the negative charge, second having the positive charge. In this diagram, NaCl electrolyte is taken and to that solution, two electrodes are added, one having the positive charge, second having the negative charge. When the electric field is applied, the positive ions move toward negative electrode and negative ion is moves to positive electrode. Thus, ions are moving to the opposite charge. Thus, in electrolytic conductor, ions get discharged when electric field is applied. And here, the electricity is produced with chemical change. You know that negative attract positive. To the negative electrode, positive ions are deposited, and to positive electrode, negative ions are deposited. So therefore, in electrolytic conductivity, it produces the electricity by producing chemical change. Now there is some difference between the metallic conductor and electrolytic conductor. Metallic conduction is carried out by the movement of electrons. In metals, only the movement of electron takes place. In metallic conductor or metallic conduction, in electrolytic conductions carried out by movement of ions. Positive ions also moving, also negative ions also moving. In metallic conductor, no change in chemical properties of the conductor. There is no chemical reaction takes place, so no change in chemical properties, whereas in electrolytic conductions, positive ions again moving, negative ions also moving. So it involves the decomposition of electrolyte as a result of chemical reactions. It involves the decomposition of electrolyte as a result of chemical change. Third number point for metallic conduction, it does not involve the transfer of any matter. Third number, it involves the transfer of matters as a ions. You are already familiar with electrolytic conductions, that positive is moving to negative electrode and negative is moving to positive electrode. So therefore, there is a transfer of matter. And metallic conduction is inversely proportional to temperature. As metallic conduction decreases, the temperature also increases. So inverse proportional. Metallic conduction decreases, temperature increases. whereas in electrolytic conductions it is directly proportional. You have to be clear about the direct and indirect proportional. Indirect means one quantity is increasing, second decreasing. Indirect means what? One decreasing, second increasing, or opposite, one increasing, second decreasing. Whereas in electrolytic conductions, it is directly proportional. So as electrolytic conduction increases, the temperature is also increases. Thank you very much. In my previous video on the syllabus of this particular unit number 1, you will find on the I buttons, also at the end screen button. Thank you.